was acquitted in a criminal trial in October 1995, though he was later found liable for their deaths in civil court. Now, here's some background on Nicole Brown Simpson. She was born in Frankfurt, West Germany. Model. was face down and barefoot at the bottom of the stairs leading to her front door, which was left open and had no signs of forced entry or any evidence that anyone had entered the premises. The scene had a large amount of blood, but the bottoms of Nicole's feet were clean, leading investigators to conclude that she was murdered first and that she was the intended target of this crime. She had been stabbed multiple times in the head and neck, but had few defensive wounds on her hands, which implied a very short struggle to investigators. The final cut was deep in her neck, severing her carotid artery. Brown did have a large bruise on the center of her upper back, so investigators concluded that after the assailant had killed Goldman, he returned to Brown's body and put his foot on her back, which caused the bruise, pulled her head back by the hair, and slit her throat. Her larynx could be seen through the gaping wound in her neck, and vertebrae C3 was incised. Her head was barely attached to her body. Underneath Brown was a restroom manual that she might have been holding. On her balance banister was a melting cup of ice cream. Her bath was full, and she had lit candles, as well as having a stereo and television on. So, by all accounts, Nicole had been settling for the night, probably gonna go enjoy a nice bowl of ice cream while taking a bath, and she was listening to the radio and watching some television, so the attacks were entirely unexpected. Goldman lay nearby, close to a tree and the fence. He had been stabbed multiple times in the body and neck, but like Brown, had relatively few defensive wounds, which also signified a very short struggle to investigators. Forensic evidence from the Los Angeles County Coroner alleged that Goldman had been attacked and stabbed repeatedly in the neck and chest with one hand while the assailant restrained him in an arm chokehold. Near Goldman were his beeper and his car keys, as well as the assailant's blue knit cap and left hand glove, an extra large iris isotoner light leather glove. Okay, so that's the brand, Iris Isotoner light leather glove. Robert Risk, the first officer at the scene, testified to seeing a single bloody glove among the other evidence at the crime scene. Also near Goldman was an envelope containing the glasses he was returning. Bloody shoe prints leaving the scene through the back gate were left by the assailant. To the left of some of the footprints were drops of blood, which apparently indicated that they were bleeding from their left hand. There were also coins on the ground from the assailant reaching into his pocket. Measuring the distance between steps showed the assailant had walked away rather than ran. Police eventually charged Nicole's ex-husband with the brutal murders, setting into motion an emotional and radically charged and racially charged criminal trial that ended with a jury acquittal of him in October 1995. Now, here's a little bit about the aftermath. The victim's families gained some measure of vindication in February 1997 when O.J. Simpson was found liable for the wrongful deaths at the conclusion of a civil trial. He was ordered to pay $8.5 million in compensatory damages to the Goldmans, as well as $25 million in punitive damage to be split between Goldman's and Nicole's children. Nicole Brown Simpson's body was buried at the Ascension Cemetery in Lake Forest, California, forever connected to one of the most notorious trials of the late 20th century. She became a subject of interest again with the casting and production of American Crime Story, a miniseries about the murder, and subsequent legal battles scheduled to air on FX in early 2016. So, unless you've been under a rock, everyone has heard of the O.J. Simpson murder trial and the controversy that came about when he was found innocent of